In this video, you will get an overview of alerts feature of Sellerboard. Sellerboard is a profit dashboard and much more. And meet a co-founder, Vladi, in this video. He will be explaining all the alerts features. So, by the way, if you want to check the Sellerboard and sign up for 2 months trial, you will find the links below in the description of this video. And also, don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel of Orange Klik, click notification bell as well, because here we talk with different Amazon experts and software creators. Hello, Vladi. It's nice to have you here. So please introduce us to your tool called Sellerboard.
Hello, AUGUSTAS. Thanks for having me. So I'm the co-founder and CEO at Sellerboard. Sellerboard is a profit analytics tool for Amazon sellers with a bunch of additional functionality on top of this. So our focus is to basically to show you your true profit numbers in real time and as accurately and user-friendly as possible. And on top of that, we have things like Inventory Manager, which reminds you to reorder, and a Refund Finder, which finds goods that were lost and damaged by Amazon, and make sure you're reimbursed for this. We have a PPC bid automation module. We have an alerting system which monitors important events on your listing, like buy box loss and so on, notifies you, and a lot of other stuff. So basically, profit analytics plus a bunch of useful tools for Amazon sellers.
All right. So let's talk about your Sellerboard feature called alerts. So what can we do with that, and how does it work?
Sure. So, we're here in Sellerboard, and if you're familiar with the profit analytics already, then you know what this is. If no, basically this is the dashboard which shows you like your profit and your sales numbers by day and by product, and with a bunch of different visualization options. There's a chart, there's a profit and loss table, and so on. So here, for example, we see what we sold today and what's the net profit, and here it's broken down by product. And we can dive into every parameter and so on. And alerts, basically, these are two new like menu items. One is here, alerts, and one is this bell. And if there's anything important in your account, then you will see directly on this dashboard. So this bell will have a notification icon. And this shows you like these alerts. And in this case, you can see a product here and what exactly happened with this product. So number of sellers changed and you lost the buy box. Or here's another product like stock alerts. Okay, so you're going to be soon running out of stock and it's time to place another order. So yeah, this is the dashboard view. And if you want to have it like really detailed, then you click on this alerts button or menu. And here's what you see here. So basically, these are all alerts tracked by Sellerboard, sorted by date, and you always see the alert type and the product and some additional information. So let's look at this one. For example, category changed. Yeah, so it says like the category on this listing was changed. And actually, the kind of alerts, the alert types, and the notification method you can configure here under settings. So let me go here. So you can see all the events that we're tracking here, and you can configure how you want to get notified and if you want to get notified at all. So in the first column, you see Sellerboard. This means if you check this column, you will get a notification in the dashboard through this bell, which I just showed, and you'll be seeing the notification in the list. But you can additionally subscribe to an email. So every event, basically, we can notify on via email. Now let me walk you quickly through these events. So yeah, brand changed. In this case, it's not configured, but it's actually a very important one. If a hijacker goes ahead and changes your brand on your listing, this is important to understand. And especially if you have like 100 listings, or maybe even 30 listings, and you're selling on different marketplaces, it's hard to track them, you're not like opening every single listing every day, right? And checking for changes. So this would be too much work. And this is basically what Sellerboard is doing. So as soon as we identify that the brand has changed, we're gonna notify you. Then buy box lost, actually you can also get these emails from Amazon, but just in case you want to have everything in Sellerboard, we have this too. Category changed. This might be a hijacker, this might be Amazon. And why is it important to know when a category changes? Sometimes the commission will change as well. And like if you're unlucky, then you're going to be paying more commission basically as soon as Amazon places your product in another category. And this is something you should check. And if the new category is wrong, then just contact Amazon and open a support ticket to make sure it's corrected. A child lost their parent. Okay, it's about parent listings and child listings. Basically, if a listing becomes an orphan because the parent listing was removed, or your child was moved to another parent, or basically to no parent in this case, this is also something you want to check and see what's going on. This might be a hijacker. Then things like commission changed, dimensions changed, or FBA fee changed. This is also important because here you're gonna. You might start losing money, right? So if Amazon changes the dimensions for some reason and or the FBA fee, then it might be that you start paying more for every single item shipped. And this is something you want to take care of. So as soon as you get notified by Sellerboard here, go ahead and take a look and open a support ticket and make sure this gets fixed. So this is a real profit killer here. Okay, then things like listing closed. This might be because your listing was banned. Listing text changed or title changed. This is a sign for hijackers as well. If somebody goes ahead and manipulates your listing, maybe puts a slightly different product into your listing, or and sometimes it's done by Amazon. Then you just probably want to know and make sure the new text is okay. Main image, same thing. So hijackers might sometimes go ahead and take your listing, basically use the reviews and put a totally different text and image into the listing. And if you don't notice it, then it's a real trouble because you're going to still be shipping your true products, although customers might be buying, judging by the new image. So this is a problem. The negative merchant feedback, or actually it should say negative or neutral merchant feedback. Sure, you might be checking this manually every day, but there's a notification for this. Okay, and then some more, like again, parent, new parent. This means your listing was moved to a new parent, ASIN. This is also something you want to check. Number of sellers. Oh, okay, this is also a sign for hijackers or piggybackers, right? If you have like 30 listings, it's sometimes hard to detect that there's a new seller on your listing. And this is something you want to act on, because if you're a private label seller you're basically the only seller of your goods, right? There's no way another seller can sell the same product. So either it's a fake, or this is some kind of a dropshipper, or in any case, something you want to take care of. And stock alerts, this is what I mentioned already. This is our inventory manager, which basically reminds you when it's time to reorder. So when you sign up for Sellerboard, this alerting is included. Basically, you get the profit analytics stuff and everything else, and the alerting is included, and it's on by default, but you can still go ahead and click alerts and settings and reconfigure it the way you need it. But by standard, we notify about most important events already. And basically, there's nothing else you need to do. You will just get notified if Sellerboard detects an important event.
So it's a nice feature that you can send alerts to your email address. One question. So how often are these alerts are sent by email? Because if I will tick all the checkboxes, maybe it will be too many email.
Yeah, so we always send one email per day, right? So if you have multiple alerts, you'll have basically multiple alerts in one email, but it's always one email per day at most, right? So if there were no alerts, then of course you will get no email.
All right. Thank you very much, Vladi. And those who are watching this video, you will find the links below to sign up for Sellerboard. And it's quite affordable and very wide used application as far as I know. So thank you, Vladi, and good luck in your business. Bye bye.
Thank you, Augustus.
If you would like to try Sellerboard for 2 months for for free, check the links below in the description of this video. And now I invite you to watch another video with a Sellerboard and to see other features, how they do and what they do. All right, here. You're still here.